Okay, so you have Young Philly.
Yeah. Oh, my babes.
Sideman.
Oh, and another babes.
Osh.
Next Lifetime. Oh, this one's going to get me in some trouble. Okay, wait.
Happy Valentine's Day, guys. Welcome to Hot and Juicy Presents, if you can't take the heat. Today's episode is all about love, sensuality, and we're going to crank up the heat and get a little bit naughty. And today's guest is all about that. Plus she acts, plus she models. Sis has secured the bag. You can't tell her. Please give a loving welcome to Jourdan.
Is it normal that I'm sweating already?
Don't sweat. Ooh. Unless you're sweating because you love.
Love is in the air and spice. I feel like I can smell the heat, but I'm here for it. I'm here for it. It's a vibe. Okay,
whoa,
I'm ready.
Oh, you know, let's crank up the heat. Because you can take the heat.
It's okay. We're about to see. Maybe I can.
All right, then. Let's go on to prawn one.
I feel like can you imagine if I can't even take number one? It's game over already. Oh, it's so good.
Yeah?
Okay.
Are you good?
Mm-hmm.
So today's episode is all about love.
Yes.
We may get a little bit freaky.
Okay, that's the best part.
So I think it's only normal to, you know, obviously talk about your time on Love Island.
Of course.
However, we already watched your time on Love Island.
Yes.
We've seen all the interviews, so yes, we already know everything. So I want to talk about the aftermath of Love Island.
Ooh.
Like, how was the whole dating experience once you broke up with Danny, once you became this Love Island influencer? And
I'm so happy you did it like that as well. It's the best way.
Yeah.
Influencers.
Yeah.
Yep.
So how was the whole dating scene, like, after Love Island? Like, how has it been?
Really hard. So it's been, God, it's over a year already. Since we actually broke up, it's been a year and 3 months, so a long time. I can't lie, I don't know how to date. Thought I'd be all right at it. Not smooth at all. Like, I thought I'd be like, oh, doesn't work that way for me. I feel like my trust issues are like I find it very hard to trust, mainly because one of the leading things people lead with is either the show, or I've seen you on this, or you and Danny that. So it makes me kind of instantly put my guards up. I'm not really a fan of dating apps. Like, I just, not a fan. I've really tried hard when I came off the show to keep myself to myself, and I probably done it a bit too well. Like, now I'm alone.
But why is that? Why did you, like, come off the show and kind of, like, wanted to, like, seclude yourself? And why has it affected your dating?
Mainly because, one, the hate was just a joke. So I was like, do you know what? I'd rather people be like, oh, she's the irrelevant one, and keep myself out of blogs, out of drama, out of press. Like, that's not me. But two, when I came off the show, I realized how much I valued my privacy. And then I realized how little privacy you get once you've come off. So it was very much like, okay, I'm just going to take myself away. But that meant that when I wasn't going anywhere, wasn't meeting anyone. I've just got my same friends around me that I've had for years. I do prefer it that way, but I feel like after a while, like, it's time to, like, get out and just start talking to people.
Dating. Speaking about that, let's go on to prawn number two. You ready?
No, but okay.
Come on, you can do it.
I can do this. I feel like my nose is already running because it's preempting what's coming. That's good. Oh my God, I can taste the difference though. How am I gonna get to that? Oh my God. How am I gonna get to that? You look wicked, man.
No, not even.
I'm on the second one, I'm ready, like, I mean, I can definitely take that, but I can already taste the dramatic difference.
If you can take that, that means that you can take up to number four.
Can I smell it? If I put it to the camera, can they smell it?
I feel like you're the second person that has actually smelt the sauce.
I've just singed all my nose hairs.
Girl, you can do this.
So dramatic.
You can do this. If you can talk so explicitly on, like, YouTube, you can take some heat.
Do you know what? It's true. I need to up my tolerance.
Yeah, and that brings me on to, you know, my second question, and we're talking about, you know, girls talk.
Yes, love it. It's literally my favorite thing ever.
So when it comes to Valentine's Day, or okay, no, the first date on Valentine's Day, right? Are you somebody who, you know, you're not going to smash on the first date? Or are you somebody that would, you know what, if the vibe is right,
like, and the sexual tension is building up.
Yeah, would you be like, let's go get a coffee?
No, I still ain't smashing on the first date, or the second, or the third. I don't know why. Maybe that's the small part. Maybe like my wall is now like a hedge.
Mm.
It's like a little mini wall that I need to just step over instead of jump over. It's just something I've never done. Not to say I won't. I feel like I've never had any part or any phase in my life where I've just been like, oh, screw it, I'm doing this, this and this. So yeah, I don't, first, second, third ain't happening. After that, we can chat.
Ain't that. Round number three.
Oh. Oh, I was hoping you forgot. Okay. I feel like, is there spice on the prawn itself already? Oh, sugar. Okay. I feel like that one's going to kick in a minute, though. I feel like in about 3 seconds, I'm going to be like, oh, damn. Okay, I can feel it. Oh, that's all right. Okay, I'm good.
I was just assessing the whole, you know.
My teeth clean. I feel like I can feel it here.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
And the other
here.
One.
Right. Put this bit in and zoom in. Zoom in.
Teeth check.
Honestly. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Okay, we're good.
Okay, so let's play a little game.
Oh, God. Okay.
Okay. So, smash, marry, maybe next lifetime.
She's a vibe, you know.
She is.
She's oozing sensual.
My hair
goddess.
Is dedicated to you, Miss Badu.
She is.
Number one, you have Denzel Washington. Fine. Piece of Old Spice. You have Travis Scott. And then you have Michael B. Jordan. Marry, smash, maybe next time.
Oh, okay. Oh, sugar.
Mm.
Travis Scott is definitely maybe next lifetime.
Really?
Yeah, I'm so sorry. Do you know what it is? When him and Kylie had their daughter, who is just one of the most beautiful little girls ever, there was a meme that came out.
Mm.
And it was a screenshot of him like jumping around singing, and his hair was like all in the air, and he was literally mid-scream. And someone wrote as the caption, "This is what Kylie sees when they have missionary sex." And I can't, for the life of me, unsee this blurred picture of him literally screaming. His hair was like this. I can't do it. I can't unsee it. So it's a no. It's a no for me. So it's gonna have to be next lifetime.
I need to see that picture.
I'm gonna find it because. I can't unsee it. It's mad. It was wild. Smash or marry? I'd probably marry Michael mm-hmm. because...
He's sexy. He's fine.
He's a really nice guy.
He's intelligent.
Yeah, he's...
The list goes on.
His personality is absolutely lovely. And then I'd smash...
Denzel.
And do you know what? If Michael wasn't in there, I probably would have married Denzel because he's just, I feel like he's marriage material.
Okay, so let's
but
take, okay, round two. And it's the final round. Okay, so you have Young Philly.
Yep. Oh, my babes.
Sideman.
Oh,
and
another babes.
Osh.
Next lifetime. Oh, this one's going to get me in some trouble. Okay, wait. I'd marry Philly. Because he just has a heart of gold. Like, I absolutely love him. So I'd marry Philly. Oh, God. Okay. Wait, what's left? Smash and next lifetime.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to have to next lifetime Osh.
Really? And smash. So,
yeah, because Sideman, I also love him with my whole heart too. And I feel like if I next lifetime him, it's just peak. I can't do that to him. But it's also...
Rah.
This is hypothetically speaking, like it, yeah.
No. Yeah, oh, you guys know it's hypothetically speaking.
Because, no.
Saying that,
Oh, I
forgot. Prawn number four. Prawn number four.
Do you see the taxes? They distract you and then they bun up your mouth. You're not smart. Oh man! And I know the prawn is spicy as is. You lot are wicked and gentle, man.
You can do it. You can do it. That was a big bite as well.
Mm-hmm. Wait, what's happening now? That one's calm. That one, number three, low key.
Like
a little bit in my face.
This is what I said. I said when it, you can go up to prawn number four and you'll be fine.
Well, three like, makes you think four's gonna be mad.
Yeah.
That's why I said I feel like the last three are gonna be a bit, because three was definitely hot.
So Jourdan.
Yeah.
You are all about your bag. Let's talk about your success, because 100%. Yeah, we're talking today's all about love, yeah. But if you are a hot girl or a city girl, it's all about securing the bag.
Get your coins.
Get your coins.
Yeah, that's all I care about. I'm not going to lie.
So let's talk about your businesses. So you're a influencer.
Yeah.
But you are an actual successful businesswoman.
Did everyone hear that? Because I feel like people troll me too much. So I just want
to. I'm not just saying that because I'm interviewing her. No, you actually have your ish in the bag.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's bag.
So, for those who don't know, tell them, look at the camera and tell them what you have secured.
My coins. I have along the lines of beauty, I have to do it in like a roundabout, but direct, but roundabout way, line coming out next year. Actually, it was meant to be this year, but Jesus, these things take so long. And in a pandemic, that comes out next year. May or may not have been able to secure mortgages on houses.
She's done it.
May or may not just be getting my coin and in the process of sorting out my house in America, which should have been done this year as well, but pandemic.
Ooh, it's a pandemic. What part of America?
LA.
So basically, I'm going to LA next year.
Oh, let's go.
So can I stay in your house?
Of course. Okay. Let's go.
Please don't just do this because we're sitting in front of each other. Join you a good 3 months after.
Yeah, let's go.
And
hun,
don't piss me off, because I'm going to, if I DM you and you don't see it,
text me.
I've got Jourdan's number now. Don't talk to me.
We'll go there, make money, and live like, that's it.
Do you get what I mean?
That's actually it. It's hard.
In saying that, it's prawn number five.
I'm surprised I even got to this point. I'm not going to lie to you. I thought by now I would have been on the floor in stitches.
See? You can do it. You put your back into it.
There's like a deep layer. They can't tell me that isn't dipped. I don't even want to bite it.
I'm gonna even eat the whole prawn.
Mine's too big.
Light work.
For you, my mouth's on fire. Oh shit, sorry.
Listen. That bite.
Okay, wait. I told you, I can't feel the left side of my tongue. I should have put it in the middle, so it dispersed it. The whole left side of my numb. I'm delirious now. So what happens? Now I can't even talk.
You're doing fine. I think you're doing a great job.
I think I'm hot.
It's cool. You've got
okay, it's stopped now.
Yeah, you good?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, cool. So we're on a date.
I lied. Okay.
So we're on a date.
Mm-hmm.
I'm your perfect man.
Mm.
Your mouth is burning.
Mm-hmm.
How do you stay? How do you keep your composure? And just, you know.
Oh, you want me to?
I want you to demonstrate. Like, so this is day, you've had the peppers gone down the left side of the tube and you're just thinking, crap. So how would you then just, you know, keep your composure?
I'd probably just keep talking for it. And just apologize if I start slurring because my mouth is on fire. Like, I'm just gonna let you know that, like, the left side of my mouth is a little bit spicy. I think whatever pepper I had stayed there. So if you see that it's drooping, nothing's wrong. I just can't feel the left part of my tongue. Then I'll just probably ask him about him, or you about you, because we're on a nice seductive date. Mm-hmm. So I can stop talking. I'll just be like, you know, I'd sat there like this.
You're good.
Tell me more.
That's really good.
If you know the way my tongue, I'm lifting it up to the roof of my mouth so I can't feel it on my teeth. Because I feel like all my... I feel like all my gums are just...
Jourdan. Oh, God. Oh, God. As sexy as that was, we're going on to prom 6.
No, we're not.
Oh, yes, we are. Oh.
Okay. I don't feel like that was the smart thing to do. But... So you spice the prawns too? Wicked generals. All right, cool.
I'm not a general. I'm not the one that cooks the food. So it's just general.
That's true.
Right.
I think I don't know about Samantha. All right.
No, you were given the more juicier prawns.
I wonder why.
Because they're juicier. I got the skinny prawns.
Oh my God. Oh my God, my throat. That one just, it doesn't even taste good. Like, why do people like this much spice? Like, it's, I can't taste anything now. Because, wow. That's mad.
It will do you some good. You'll do some good in life. Just have some spice in your life.
No, see, number 3 and 4 I can live with.
So I was watching your last YouTube video. When
can everyone see that my hands are shaking?
I just want to say that Jourdan is going like this.
You're a liar. No, I'm not. Tell me I'm doing it. Tell me I'm going like this. Go on. You're too bad, man. Mm-hmm.
Your last episode of Girls Talk, you randomly called your friends, unbeknown to them, and you asked them some personal questions.
Very personal questions, actually. Yeah,
in regards to sex.
Yes. The best topic ever.
One of the callers was our very own Miss Coco.
She was.
You want them to pick number on that down.
Their hormones take over their life.
He's supposed to pull it back and wash that cheese.
Leave it all up her belly and everything.
Favourite place in the house to have sex?
And so I just want to ask, okay?
I'm listening to you. I'm just distracting myself from the heat.
What is the most awkward / embarrassing position you've been in sexually?
It was actually my first boyfriend who I actually lost my virginity to. We were outdoors somewhere. It was a public place, but it wasn't so public that anyone should have been there. But apparently we weren't the only rule breakers in life.
Oh. Okay.
So some other people just, you know, happened to break into the fence that we'd happened to jump over to and hide and walk right past us. But it was dark. And not only did they walk past us, well, this was the embarrassing part. They decided to realize that other people were there, which freaked them out because obviously none of us should have been there in the first place. Flashlights went on, phone lights went straight on. And it was an awkward scenario, awkward position, even more so. More so for him more than me in this aspect, but me, because as a female, that's just the last thing you want. And I also didn't know whether the light was their phone lights or they were recording. So I was like, well, this is even more uncomfortable.
Was this before or after popularity?
Before. We.
Okay. Yeah. We just... Shea Bro, I would have had...
They are... he who shall not be named. What happened was I just happened to be on top. And, well, I stood up in a panic. So, you know, he was a little bit revealed. It's a little bit exposed. So it was more embarrassing as well because then the two people that had broken were breaking in with the same intentions by the looks of things. They were planning to do the same thing. And it was like, one girl was like, light on me, light on him, light on me. He was just laying there, butt naked, just exposed.
Hold on, I want to ask a question. So hold on, you were getting a little quickie in public, but you laid on him.
It wasn't necessarily that quick, but yeah.
Oh.
No, I was on top.
You on top?
I was on top.
So he was laying on the floor?
No, we had a blanket.
Oh.
It was very planned. Very planned. We had to break into a particular area. We had to jump a fence and all sorts. We were not supposed to be there. So we didn't think anyone else would be there.
This is a talk for girls talk.
It was, and I was a lot younger as well. So that's what was even worse, is that I was like, oh my God, my mum's going to beat me. I thought it was going to end up on the news, like all that kind of nonsense. So yeah, got caught.
Good, before you go, oh, how can I forget?
Well,
okay, so are you in a loving mood or are you in a bit of a naughty mood? So
I get to choose.
This is naughty and this is loving. So which hand would you like?
I would have normally gone for naughty because that's just a little bit of me. But because it's Valentine's, we're going to go for loving mood.
Okay.
I love a little bit of love.
So
what have you...
Happy Valentine's Day!
Oh, and they're my favorite. They're so cute.
I know.
Oh no, but see, now I've come with my two left hands. My mum always told me not to do that.
No, it's okay. We should always
receive. Look, they're so cute.
I know, we're precious out here.
They're so unique. I love them so much.
No, they're beautiful.
I love them. Thank you.
You're
okay,
welcome.
I'm gonna give you your gift off camera, because you know it's a secret and whatnot.
Can we make a TikTok video as well?
Oh my God, yes.
Oh my God.
Can we?
And in saying that, guys,
is that right?
The end of today's episode. We're going to make a TikTok video. I'm Felicia Olutie. This is Hot and Juicy Presents If You Can't Take the Heat. Jourdan, thank you.
Thank you.
See you guys next time.